Welcome to another video from far north bushcraft and survival. My name is Lonnie and behind the camera is my wife Connie. And today's video I want to discuss the spruce tree. The spruce tree is incredibly useful. It's one of the most useful trees here in the north country. So let's go through a few of its uses. All right, before we get started on this, on discussing the spruce tree, I want to take this just a few seconds here to thank all those folks who have been donating to the channel. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you. All right, let's get into this this video. Now, one of the most useful aspects of the spruce tree is spruce pitch. Okay, some people call it resin. There's several different names for it. What is it useful for? Okay, right here, you may see a little bubble, a little blister right here. Okay, this happens to be a white spruce. Okay, can you see that drip on the knife tip there? Okay, if you have a wound, just spread this on the wound, and this will not only speed up healing, but it also oftentimes help to reduce pain. Okay, what kind of wounds? Well, any open wound, it's a good antibacterial to not only prevent infection, but it also aids in the healing process. But another injury that it's very useful for is burns. Spruce pitch is good for burns. Now, of course, any of this medicinal info, it should go without saying, you know, go to your doctor first. But if you're out in the middle of the woods and there are no doctors, be sure and keep this in mind, the spruce pitch. Okay, now, this is a white spruce tree, and there's a few blisters on this, you know, so there's plenty of spruce pitch available, but oftentimes you can't find these blisters, or you don't even have a white spruce or other conifers who have these. So then what do you do? Okay, let's take a little walk. If you can't find any of those blisters, the next choice would be to look for the clear pitch. It looks like almost like a drip of water. Okay, let's go up here. Here's another one right here. Hopefully you can see those in the camera lens. All right, let's go back down here to this one. Now, hopefully in the camera lens you can see the light reflecting off of this, bouncing off of this. So what if you get injured at night and you need some first aid? Okay, well, turn on a flashlight or a headlamp, and these clear bits of pitch, they really show up. In fact, they're easier to find at night than they are during the day because they reflect the light back to you. Okay, so how do you use them? Okay, this one is fairly liquid still, and it's easily spread. Now, oftentimes what you find, this one is pretty easy too. Oftentimes what you find, especially during the winter, is, now hopefully you can see in the camera, that's my finger, my hand right there is pretty well coated in pitch. Now during the winter, these will still be available on the tree, but they'll be hard. So what you do is you place the hard ball on the injury and you just hold your finger there, if your finger's warm enough, and just hold it there, and it will soften up and melt, and then you can then rub it in. Now, if you can't find any of that that clear, here's some right here. But let's just say you can't find any. Well, then the hard yellow would be your next choice, and you'd have to use some way of melting this, heating it, perhaps on a rock. Put a rock in the fire and heat the rock up until it's warm, and then lay these pieces on that rock until they liquefy. Now, you don't want to put hot pitch, of course, on an injury, so be mindful of how hot you heat it up, how hot you apply it. Here's another use for spruce pitch. This cleaner yellow type spruce pitch, just gathered up as much as you'll need, and put it in your mouth. It makes a great gum, and in fact, that is traditionally what gum was made from, was spruce pitch. It looks like gum, it chews like gum. It's a little bit softer, and maybe I need to chew a little bit faster, so as to not let it sit. If you just hold it, sometimes you'll get it stuck in your teeth. Okay, now here's another use for the pitch. I'm going to collect up some of this. Well, right here, this is this should be plenty right here. All right, now let's gather us some these dead spruce twigs. Now, the night before last, it was raining, and everything got pretty wet, but as you can hear, these spruce twigs are very dry, so it's going to make good fire starter. Now, here is some usnea, and we'll get into that a little bit later. Discuss the usnea or usnea. But as long as it's dry, it makes a good fire starter. All right, we'll come back when we're set up, and we're going to light a fire with this. I'll show you my favorite method of using this to light a fire. Now, all around me is lots of snow. We still have a lot of snow to go yet this spring. So this right here looks like a great place to light a fire, but in reality, it's not a good place at all. As you can see, there's deep piles of old dead spruce needles, and oftentimes there could be organic soil below here. And if a fire gets started in that organic soil, it could continue to burn and spread underground unknowingly. You know, it may be apparently out, but it could spread underground and then pop up elsewhere and start a forest fire. So you want to make sure that you're on mineralized soil. Now, I see here, we're actually on a trail. And if you dig down here far enough, you can get down to, it looks like some of it is mineralized and some of it is not. So, this you can tell is mineralized, and this would be fine to light a fire on. But this over here looks like it's partly organic. So, what we're going to do especially since we're not going to be burning very long here, is we're just going to light it on top of the snow. So what I like to do is lay a little bed of sticks, lay my spruce pitch on top of that, and then here's one case where matches really shine. Pardon the pun. This is where matches are a benefit. Okay, I strike the match and I just lay it right on the pitch like that. And once that pitch gets burning, then the fire is pretty assured. And this usnea or usnea, it is hydrophilic or hydroscopic. It absorbs water, it likes water. So if there's high humidity, it will absorb water. But even with all of that water in this, even if this is damp, in the, like in a rain, it will still dry out on a small pitch fire like this and light. So let's get this, let this, while this is starting to burn on its own, let's talk about some other things. What else is, you know, we've discussed medical uses for spruce pitch. Is spruce pitch good for anything else? Well, if you know of some things that it's good for that I don't mention, feel free to mention it in the comments. But one thing, an age-old use for spruce pitch, is it was one of the first, if not the first, adhesive. This makes pretty good adhesive glue. It's good for sealing things. It was used extensively for putting a birch bark canoe, the birch portion of a birch bark canoe together to seal the joints to make them waterproof. It was used for attaching arrow fletching to the to an arrow shaft. So, pretty useful. Now, how you do that, I won't go into it in depth here, but you mix the spruce pitch on its own can be very brittle. You don't want it to be brittle, so you're going to need to mix it with something. Something like rabbit droppings. Ground up, dried, of course, and ground up, mixed in, and perhaps a little bit of charcoal ground up into a powder and mixed in. That will tend to make it a little more flexible, a little more forgiving, so it won't crack and bust up. All right, now, as we saw here, the usnea. Usnea, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. It is very medicinal as well. It is a lichen, and it doesn't grow just on spruce trees. It grows on many different trees. It grows on just about all of the trees that we have around here. Willow, alder, birch, cottonwood, poplar, and spruce. So, what's it good for? It is antiseptic, it's antibacterial, and it's antifungal, and it's antiviral. This, let me back up a little bit here from the fire. Yes, it's antiviral. Okay, right now there is a worldwide episode, I will call it, of viral nature. We won't go any more in depth than that because I want this video to get out to the people. And So this is antiviral. Now, I'm not going to tell you how to use it. I prefer that you do your own research. Also, there's other lichens that look alike, similar. Okay, in some of my other videos, I showed how to know what is Usnea and what is not. I showed how to tell if this is Usnea. I showed how to find out. Okay, we won't get into that. So, what is it good for on a practical level, a simple level? This is dried. I could have used the fresh had it been dry, but it wasn't. It's dampish. So, what you can do with it is take this dried and agitate it. I don't know how to explain it here, but you know, do what I'm doing here. Agitate it, and it's a lichen. It's made up of fungi and algae, a symbiotic relationship between the two. Well, you'll get a powder, a green powder, and I don't know whether this is the algae or the fungi, but this dropped into a wound is also antiseptic, and will help the wound to heal. Now, you want to clean it up. You don't want a lot of debris in it, just pretty much the clean powder. I hope that shows up well in the video, in the camera. Okay, what else is this good for? Okay, I've used it for athlete's foot. Just take it and sprinkle it over your toes, wherever you have a problem, rub it in a little bit, and that'll repeated usage of that will help solve that problem. All right. Another use for this is as deodorant. You know, take that powder and rub it under your arms, and it can be used as a deodorant. Okay, let's go on to other uses of the spruce tree. Here is another useful item on the spruce tree. Probably most of you are aware of spruce needle tea. It is an excellent tea. It's one that I really enjoy. Now, during the springtime is the most traditional way of getting the leaves, the fresh new growth. But needles like this, even on the older trees, they're perfectly fine to use all year long for spruce tea. And what you want to do is you want to take just the tips here like this and use them. Boil your water, put your tips. What I like to do is I like to basically fill the container with the spruce needle tips, and boil your water, pour the boiling water over them, let them steep until you have your desired level of flavor. The reason why I like to fill the container is I like lots of flavor, and that will give you some good spruce flavor. Now, another couple of useful things for spruce boughs is they make a good shelter covering to create a roof out of the spruce boughs. Now, you'll need to lay them in such a way that they will hopefully help to shed the rain. So because of their porous nature, this is what you're going to use as a shelter covering, it's going to need to be fairly steep, the roof that you place this on. Another way of using these is you have a pole framework for your roof. Throw several boughs on top of that roof, and that will help fill in the gaps so that then you can go on and say cover it with leaves and other debris that would have fallen through had you not used a little bit of covering. Okay, another thing that the spruce needles are good for, spruce branches, is they're pretty good at insulating. Now, insulation is not the item per se. It's kind of hard to explain. It is air. And because of the porous nature of these needles, a pile of the spruce needles traps a lot of air. Not only does it trap a lot of air and provide insulation of a sort in and of itself, but it also can separate you from the ground. So it makes a good cover to lay on, you know, to spread on the ground to sleep on. Now you're going to want a good packed 6 inches if your ground is cold like we have here in Alaska. But this will work very well as a ground cover, an insulative ground cover. All right, now, another thing that spruce trees are good for, of course, they make an excellent firewood, not due to the quality of the spruce as a firewood so much as due to its prevalence in areas where people are, rural backwoods Alaska, spruce are just about everywhere. And so because of that, they are used extensively as a firewood. Now, BTU ratings, the hardwoods would be a better choice, such as our birch we have here in Alaska, but the birch isn't always as available as the spruce tree is. Now, another thing is the inner bark of the birch, or the spruce, excuse me. That has traditionally been used, as well as many other trees, as for its nutritional value. It's been used as a food. It's been used as a flower, not really a flower substitute, but a flower extender. It would work better as a flower extender. And how you would use it would be you would take the inner bark, the cambium of the spruce tree, which is underneath of this outer covering, in between this outer covering and the actual wood of the tree. You would take that, dry it, and then you'd have to grind it up into a powder to use that. Also, that works as a good foot powder, ground up, powdered up spruce bark. It's antiseptic, and it works good as a foot powder. Now, I have also shown in some of my past videos how you can take the spruce bark cambium, you can cut it up into small little bits and grind it up a little bit, with a rock, just to break it up a little bit more and chew on it. You can get nutritional value out of it like that, raw. Now, one final aspect of the spruce tree that I want to discuss is spruce roots. Spruce roots are a fantastic cordage, ready-made cordage. You get that underneath of the spruce tree, of course. Now, my favorite area of getting that is in areas of deep moss, where it's the whole ground is pretty much clean of all or most other bushes. It's just moss. That way, any root that you come across, you can be pretty sure that root is a spruce root. The reason why spruce roots are favored is because of their durability, their strength. Now, I did a video where I dug up a spruce root. I tied it onto a bow of a friction fire set, and I made an ember using that spruce root. And you can see that video right up here. Okay, now what if you don't have spruce root available, but you do need some natural cordage for a bow drill or for something else? Well, here's another alternative. Okay, this is a willow. It's been damaged, perhaps by a moose chewing on it, but the inner bark here makes a great cordage. Now, there's not much of it exposed here. Most of the inner bark is gone, but here's a nice piece. It is very flexible as long as it's damp, still damp, hasn't dried out. It is very flexible and makes a great cordage. And I've done videos where I've used this as a cordage for a bow drill. But discussing the properties of a willow, that's really for another video and another time. Well, Connie and I would like to thank you for joining us on this video where we talked a little bit about the spruce tree and a few of its uses. I hope you learned something, and we hope to see you on the next video. You folks take care and have a good one. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.